So we'll introduce some notation. We've got this school, and I'm going to suppose that of the pupils, capital L of them are left-handed, and capital R of them are right-handed. And in this strange world, nobody is ambidextrous. So the total number of pupils in the school is L plus R. And the total number of left-handed pupils is L. So the question is asking us to work out this fraction. It implicitly assumes that there are children at the school. Otherwise, you're looking at 0/0. You don't want to go there. So this school contains at least one pupil. Right, we're now given some information about eye colour. So let's suppose that the number of students at the school with blue eyes is capital B. And we're given two ways to work that out. We're told that a fifth of the students at the school have blue eyes, so that means that B is equal to the total school population, L plus R, divided by 5. But we're also told the information about left-handed and right-handed students separately. 1/10 of the left-handed students have blue eyes, and 1/4 of the right-handed students have blue eyes. So these two different ways of working out B are great because it allows us to put an equal sign between these two quantities and forget about blue eyes forevermore. We've just got an equation between L's and R's. Now, it's mildly unpleasant because it's got these denominators. We want to clear them, and we can make them go away if we multiply by 20. So multiply both sides of this equation by 20. Well, the first factor of 5 makes this denominator disappear, and you're left with wanting to multiply L plus R by 4. Now, 4 lots of L plus R is the same as 4L plus 4R. So we've done that. Now let's look at what happens over here. We've got two things added together, and we want to multiply them by 20. So what we want is 20 lots of this, plus 20 lots of that, so we can do it separately. When you multiply L over 10 by 20, well, the factor of 10 disappears and we're left with 2L on the top. There it is. When you multiply R over 4 by 20, the factor of 4 disappears and you're left with a factor of 5. And 5 lots of R is 5R. So now we've got a much more attractive looking equation. What would be great is if we knew the relationship between R and L. So what I'll do two things in one scary go. I'll subtract 2L from both sides of this equation, which will move that over here and make it a minus. And I'm also going to subtract 4R from both sides of this equation. So this 4R will disappear and appear over there as minus 4R. So let's do that. 4L minus 2L is 2L, and 5R take away 4R is just R. But now we're in business because we can get rid of R in the question we were asking. R is 2L. So this fraction becomes L over L plus 2L. The L will cancel from the top and the bottom, from the numerator and the denominator, and you'll just be left with 1/3, and that's the answer.